topic is the assignment problem. Now, what is the assignment problem? Now, objective of the assignment problem is to assign a number of origins or jobs to the equal number of destinations or persons at a minimum cost or the maximum profit. Before, we have already discussed about the transportation problem. Now, there is a something difference between the transportation problem and the assignment problem. In the transportation problem, the number of sources and number of destinations need not to be equal. Hence, the cost matrix is not necessarily a square matrix. But in the case of the assignment problem, assignment is done on one-on-one basis. So the number of sources and the number of destinations are equal. Hence, the cost matrix must be a square matrix. Today, we are using the Hungarian method to solve the assignment problem. Now, those are the particular steps. First of all, we have to consider the given matrix, that means the cost matrix. In the given problem, if the number of rows is not equal to the number of columns and vice versa, then we have to add a dummy row or a dummy column. The assignment costs for the dummy cells are always assigned as zero. Next, reduce the matrix by selecting the smallest element in each row and subtract with other elements in that row. Next, reduce the next matrix column wise, as like in the we have done for row in the step 2. Now draw, most important thing, draw minimum number of lines to cover all the zeros. If number of lines drawn is equal to the order of the matrix, then optimality is reached. Otherwise, we have to proceed to the step 7. That means we have to take any row or column which has a single zero and assign by squaring it. Strike off the remaining zeros, if any, in that row and column. Repeat the process until all the assignments have been made. Finally, we have to reach to the next part. Now, we are just doing the assignment problem using Hungarian method using an example. Let us suppose that is our cost matrix. In that particular cost matrix, already we have 4 rows and 4 columns. So that is a square matrix, so we have nothing to use any dummy row or dummy column. So in that process, already we have the order of the matrix is particularly order of the matrix is 4. Now the first step. Let's consider the rows. In the first row, we have a minimum cell value assigned is 13. And the next, that is 20. So, particularly we are using that value for the first row, which one is minimum 13. So that is 20 minus 13, and that one we are getting is 7. Next, 28 minus 13, or we are getting, that is 15. For the next one, 19 minus 13, 6, and 13 minus 13, 0. In the same way, the next row, 15 is the minimum, so we are getting 15 minus 15, 0. 30 minus 15, 15, 31 minus 15, 16, and 28 minus 15, that one, 13. In the same way, for the next two rows, for the third row, the minimum value 17, and for the fourth row, minimum value 12, we are getting the third row and fourth row. The next step, we have to proceed according to the column. Now in the first column, minimum value already we have reached, that is 0, so the there is no change in the first column. For the second column, look, the minimum value is 4, so we are subtracting 15 minus 4, we are getting 0. 15 minus 4, 11. 15 minus, 4 minus 4, that is 0. And 16 minus 4, 12. In the third column, the minimum value is once again 3. So we are getting 3, 13, 0, 11. And in the fourth column, already the minimum value was 0. So we are getting here the column as 0, 13, 0 and 0. Now already we have got some zeros and for the entire cost matrix. Now that is the most important thing. We have to draw the straight lines, or we have to cross out the zeros using minimum line. Now if we consider that line, we are crossing out 3 zeros, that line 3 zeros, and finally 1 zero is left. We may cross out that column. That means all zeros are covered and number of lines are particularly here, that is 3. But look at the order of the matrix. Order of the matrix is here 4. So that is less than the number of lines covered to cross out the 0 is less than the order of the matrix. So the optimality is never reached here. So the checking, we have to do something different. What do we have to do? Just look at the uncovered numbers or the cell values. In the uncovered cell values, we have already the lowest value is here, that one is 3. Just subtract the value 3 from each and every uncovered elements or the cell. So the first one uncovered is 11, so 11 minus 3, that is becoming 8. Next one 3, that is becoming 0. Next uncovered once again 11, 11 minus 3, that one is 8. Next uncovered, that is 13, that means we are getting 13 minus 3, that is 10. Next uncovered 12, so 12 minus 3, we are getting 9. For the next uncovered, that is 11, we are getting 11 minus 3, that is 8. Now the covered 7, 0, 9, those are becoming or unchanged, those are kept as unchanged. Next 0, 0, 0, 0, unchanged. Next one 0, 13, those are unchanged, and that one 0, that is unchanged. But look at those numbers, that is 23 and 0. Particularly, what is happening here? Now a crossing of line is occurring here. For that 23 and for that 0. So here we are not subtracting, but we have to add the plus 3 for those two values. So we are getting 23 plus 3, that is 26, and 3 here, that is 3, 0 plus 3. So once again, we have to choose the minimum cell value from the uncovered area, and for the other uncovered cell, just subtract that minimum value. And the covered line cells must be remain unchanged except those values which has a crossing of the lines must be added that particular lowest minimum cell value. So here finally we are getting that type of cost matrix. Then finally, once again we have to cover or check all the zeros are covering or not. Now the first row which has two zeros, so we are crossing out that particular row. Next, the first column we are crossing out. Third row, two zeros we are crossing out. Finally, one zero is there, that is we are crossing out the fourth column. So the number of lines covered, the number of lines covered is particularly 4, and that is equal to the order of the matrix. If we want to try the cover the zeros using less than 4, that is not possible here. So the number of lines equal to 4, that is also equal to the order of the matrix. So now the optimality has been reached. So we can proceed to the final thing. So here, at the first row, there are two zeros. So we are leaving that row. In the second row, there is only one zero. We are assigning it, and the respective column has no zero, so that is unchanged. In the next row, there are two zeros. So once again, we are leaving it. In the fourth row, there is a zero. So we are covering it, and in the respective column, there is a zero. We are crossing out this. Once again, at first we are starting from the first row, but there was two zero, so we are leaving it. In the second row, there is one zero, we are covering it, but there is no respective zero in the column, so there is nothing to do. In the third row, once again there are two zero, we are leaving it. In the fourth row, there is one zero, we are covering it, and we are also crossing out the zero in that particular column. So next we are proceeding to the column one thing. In the first column, already one zero that has been covered. In the second column, there is one zero. So we are covering that zero, and respective row zero has been crossed out. In the third column, there is only one zero. So we are covering it, and in the fourth column, the zero already has been covered. So that is our final assignment. That means for A, that is 3, for B, that is 1, for C, that is 2, and for D, that is 4. So finally, the result has been found here, that is total cost is equal to, according to the first one cost matrix values, that is 19, 15, 21 and 12, the result is 67. Now, once again, we are discussing the Hungarian method for another example. In that example, there are 5 rows and 5 columns. So the order of the matrix is here 5. So once again we are starting from the row. In the row, first row, the minimum value is 15. So we are subtracting it from each and every element of that first row. So 20 minus 5, that is 15, that is equal to 5. 15 minus 15, 0. 18 minus 15, 3. 20 minus 15, 5. And 25 minus 15, 10. In the same way, already we have found out the next four rows. Next step, according to the row, whatever we have done, that has to be done using the column. Using that column, in the first column, the minimum value is 0. So the first column remains unchanged. In the second column, once again, the minimum value is 0. So that remains unchanged. In the third column, minimum value is 0, that is unchanged. But in the fourth column, minimum value is 2. So that means 5 minus 2, 3, 2 minus 2, 0, 6 minus 2, 4, 6 minus 2, 4, 3 minus 2, 1. And in the fifth column, the minimum value is once again 3. So that is becoming 7, 0, 1, 0, 1. Now we have to draw the lines to cover all the zeros. Now the already we are seeing that in the first column there are two zeros, so we are just crossing out that column. In the second row there are three zeros, we are crossing out that column, sorry, that row. In the first row there is only one zero. In the fourth row there is 1 0. In the fifth row there is 1 0. So the number of lines here we get to cover all the zeros is equal to 5, and that is also the order of the matrix. So at that moment we can assign the cells. So in the same way, at the first row there is only 1 0, so we are assigning or covering that 0. Now in that column there is no 0, so we are proceeding to the next row. In the next row, second row, there are 3 zeros, so we are leaving that row. In the third row there is 1 0, so we are covering that 0. And in the respective column there is 1 0, so we are crossing out this. In the fourth row there is 1 0, we are covering it up. And respective column there is 1 0, we are crossing it out. In the fifth row there is only 1 0, so we are covering it up. And in the respective column there is 1 0, we are crossing it out. So in the first column, now proceeding to the column, in the first column there is only 1 0 that has been covered. In the second column that has been already been the 0 covered. In the third column 1 0 covered. In the fourth column there is 1 0 that we are covering it, and the respective rows 0 has been already crossed out. In the fifth column there is 1 0. So each and every row or column has been assigned. So the final result is here for the job 1, in the that is 2, for the job 2 that is 4, for 3 that is 1, for 4 that is 5, and for 5 that is 0. So finally we are getting, according to the cost matrix, the result is for 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 3 to 1, 4 to 5, and 5 to 3, the result is 86 hours. And that is our assignment problem using Hungarian method.